Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Wednesdays in Wiedemann, the first of 2019. And I think it's not too late to wish you a happy new year because I haven't seen you since last December. Today's program is a favorite theme of mine to combine Bach with some early French composers. As you see, these two today, Pierre Dumage and Bach, have just about the same dates. Pierre Dumage was only 10 years older than Bach. And Pierre Dumage was a student, a rather brilliant student, of Louis Marchand, which I've also played here, who was also a contemporary of Bach and was supposed to have showed up for a contest of improvisation with Bach, but never did. But that could be just folklore. But anyway, that's the anecdote that sticks with everybody concerning those two famous musicians. This Livre d'Orgue, or organ book, by Dumage is also called, he calls it a suite of eight pieces. I'm playing three, one, the first one, the last one, and then one in the middle, the basse de trompette, trumpet bass. It doesn't say what they were written for, so it had a very eclectic use for any occasion, really. A suite can be suite dance movements, which they certainly were apparent to, or any combination of the eight or less for a mass, and most certainly for vespers on a Sunday afternoon. Very often they were used then as organ responses to the Magnificat, which is the Song of Mary, during these vespers. The corresponding verses to the Magnificat of these three movements I'm playing today are very amply described with the Magnificat, and notice how the music amply describes the words. The plein jeu is the Magnificat anima mea dominum. My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Savior. The basse de trompette, which is with its very large intervals, suddenly going way down, is De posuit potentis decede, and he hath put down the mighty from their seat, and hath exalted the humble and meek. The last movement, Grand Jeu, which is a big loud one on the reeds, cornets, Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost. These are ways of listening to this music today and to have it mean something to you. So the three movements, plein jeu, basse de trompette, and grand jeu, from the Livre d'Orgue organ book by Pierre Dumage.
Thank you.
after these pieces, and the French organ so concentrated on reeds and loud reeds and cornets, now the German organ with its mixtures and its plenum. The Toccata and Fugue in F major by Bach is one of its greatest works. He didn't originally write them together, but put them together later on. These are the words of Hermann Keller, a noted Bach scholar who described this Toccata in a particularly beautiful way. At the beginning, the extensive linear construction of the two voices in canon, the proud calmness of the solos in the pedal, well, it's virtuosic, it's not too calm, but it's, the piercing chord strokes, you'll hear later, the fiery upswing of the second subject, the bold modulatory shifts, the inwardness of the three minor movements, the splendor of the end with the famous third inversion of the seventh chord. You won't know what it is, but you'll recognize what it is because it's very surprising. Who would not be enthralled by that? And then the fugue is a very different piece from the Toccata, more solemn, with two subjects. It's a double fugue. It's Bach's only thoroughgoing double fugue, where the two subjects or melodies are exposed in separate sections, one after the other, and then combined at the end. Those two, I think you'll recognize. From the bravura of the Toccata to the grandeur of the fugue, here is Bach's Toccata and Fugue in F major.